Okay, what's the crack? Paul Morrissey here, out and about on the float in Dublin. And decided to set up here in a falafel shop in Georgia Street Arcade and do a quick transfer deadline day talk, alright? All the deals are flying in. There was the swap deal between Mkhitaryan and Sanchez. Van Dijk going to Liverpool, right? Got lots of players to get through. And I decided to bring in some real expert analysis on this, alright? I'm not just going to sit here boring just like I normally do by myself. So I've got ex-Irish international here, Keith Andrews. Now, very much a renowned pundit on Off the Ball, formerly of TV3 as well. He's a real authority on the Premier League and, of course, domestic Irish football. So, Keith, first of all, absolute pleasure. Thanks, get you on my YouTube channel. Absolutely delighted. This is fun as well because I just saw him and decided on a shot to ask Keith here. So, first and foremost, Sanchez, Mkhitaryan deal. Who do you think got the best deal there? You know, your Arsenal. There's no money traded here. It was a straight swap. Very rare, actually, if that happens.
Yeah, I think it worked out. I'm hard. It's about equal for me because I feel Sanchez, if he had went to Man City, it's another step ahead of the rest. Mainly Manchester United because they're the closest to two of them. So for Manchester United to have that pulling power, they've obviously had to pay more than City were willing to pay Sanchez.
Exactly.
So that was obviously a big pull. In terms of Mkhitaryan, I'm glad he stayed in the Premier League because he's a player I like. I think he quite fits into the Mourinho type of football.
Because he doesn't work his bollocks off like Sanchez does.
Basically, gone the other way. He's an offensive type player.
Yeah. So player of the year in Bundesliga for Borussia Dortmund. And he made a good start to United initially, didn't he? But then, I mean, United have so many of that club player, Martial.
His best player, his best position is at number 10.
Yeah.
Keeps him kind of in the right on the left. He can hook him off last season, half time for the Manchester Derby. So, look, I don't think his face is quite fit there. I think that overall, I think it just works for all parties.
Made his debut last night, I don't know if you saw it. I heard it was kind of underwhelming. And Arsenal lost to Swansea last night, just as, of course, that was the player I was thinking of. Aubameyang, that's the next move we'll talk about here. So Pierre-Emerick, Aubameyang, completed his move to Arsenal. Hilariously, actually, just as they were losing to the bottom team in the league, Swansea, alright, this was a classic Arsenal fan TV night. So, penny for Aubameyang's thoughts. Keith, what do you think?
I don't think it'll particularly surprise me. Arsenal are very capable of this type of performance and result. I think it's a very good signing on their part. He may well have to tweak the system in terms of getting him and Lacazette in the same team, but he's done that in terms of being able to play three at the back.
So maybe go 3-4-2?
Possibly, yeah. It's been more of a 3-4-2-1 or a 3-4-3 at times this season.
It's getting to get some beauty board out here.
Yeah, I think he's a no-brainer in terms of signing. And it's a very type signing because there's a power shift now going on in Arsenal. Wenger hasn't got the power that he used to have. And if you look at the age profile of the team,
that's a huge January window, isn't it, to bring in two players of that calibre and quality. Yeah, so we got the thumbs up from Keith on Aubameyang. We'll have a talk about Virgil van Dijk then. The big, they broke the world record for a defender, so like 75 million quid for Virgil van Dijk, the Dutchman in here, from Southampton. So how do you think he's done so far? Obviously it's well documented how Liverpool are absolute shambles at the back, so...
I think it's a very good sign, and again, clubs are paying over the odds for players because that's the market that we're in at the moment. But in terms of him as an individual defender, a ball-playing defender, a commanding centre-half, he's as good as it gets in world football.
Yeah.
The fundamental problems at Liverpool are the way the team is set up, the way they are very vulnerable in terms of positioning full-backs and too advanced. The centre-halves are very, very vulnerable. There's not a natural hold of midfielder in front of him to provide that protection.
Yes.
So he will help, but he can't solve it all. He's not going to be the absolute.
Yeah, he can't be a panacea to all their ills. Yeah. And then who do we move on to? Yeah, Laporte. He's Emerick Laporte. Spanish-born French international, is he? There was, you know, he could have played for either France or Spain. He's eligible for either. Grew up through the Athletic Bilbao ranks, so Guardiola obviously would have known him from his days managing Barcelona. I think he's 22, 23, something like that. Ball playing centre half, very much in the ilk of what Guardiola looks for now that Company is on the way out. So.
Yeah, he's left side, so he'll give a little bit of balance there.
Is he?
Well.
Okay.
And he's uncapped by France, even though he's been in the squad.
That's it. So he's gone for France, although he could have gone for Spain. Exactly.
Look, I think again, you're talking about a fee that's probably not entirely right, but again, the market that we're in, he clearly wanted to add some little talk with Johnny Evans. I don't think they'll go straight into the team. I do think he needs to strengthen up.
Are going to get Johnny Evans, yeah?
Yeah, big talk with Johnny Evans from the sign where he will get a new contract at West Brom. Remains to be seen, but I think long term this will be a very good sign if he develops, which you would imagine he would. I want to coach him very well.
Lovely stuff. That gives a nice segue onto Daniel Sturridge move to West Brom. That was out of nowhere, wasn't
random,
it?
Very random for me.
Left field, wasn't it, man?
Talk of Sevilla, talk of maybe going to Serie A, which a lot of people would suggest it suits his style of play and the regularity of the games compared to the hustle bustle of the Premier League.
Like,
he needs recovery time. He's an issue in terms of his conditioning. He has to play two within himself. It doesn't particularly look like he plays when he's got any type of knock.
I think Steven Gerrard alluded to that in his autobiography that, you know, he's felt in front of us, it has to be 100%. That's a constant debate, isn't it? Roy Keane used to always say, play through that barrier, sure, you're never going to play if you're not 100% fit. But then Keane also contradicted himself on that, saying when he retired, he could understand the more continental way of saving yourself. How did you?
Maybe
how
he
did
was educated by other players on that front.
Yeah, maybe get a bit of your input as a professional player.
Yeah, I think it's playing through those where you have to send it back.
Did you ever have like, I think Sturridge is hammies, is it?
Yeah, and he feels like it gets tight, it's tight and off. Whereas some players may play through that.
Fast twitch, slow twitch, I suppose. Yeah. Maybe for a fast twitch striker, you need that.
Exactly. It's more explosive. Certainly, I was. Look, I think it's a very good time for West Brom. Very, very good time. They've made a lot of good, very good football clubs. And obviously, something struck a chord in terms of what impact he would have. Basically, he was going to be the main man. So for West Brom, it's an absolute cool.
Yeah. Listen, I'm not going to interrupt your falafel lunch anymore. I know you're busy. This was an absolute pleasure for me to get former Irish international Keith Andrews here, and now renowned top pundit here on Off the News Talks Off the Ball show. I saw him walking by here in George Street Arcade, and you know this is my style on YouTube. I've no like just picking up random moments like this. So this is the best vlog bomb I've ever had for sure. Keith, absolute pleasure. Absolute pleasure. We ran through the transfer deadline day. Got some real expertise thoughts, picked up some stuff I wasn't aware of about players like Laporte, for example. Absolute pleasure to get that kind of insight. And I'm going to let him back to his falafel and get back to his day, alright? So, thanks very much. Maybe just get a little subscribe plug for you. Subscribe to Paul's channel.
What is it?
Just say, please subscribe to Paul's channel.
Please subscribe to Paul's channel, everyone.
Thanks very much, Keith. Alright, guys, we'll sign off. And as Keith said, please do hit that subscribe button. Cheers. All the best.